Hello, hello. Thanks for tuning in. All right, today we're going to take a look at this BougeRV CIGS 100 watt flexible solar panel. They claim that this panel is 360 degrees flexible, and it's a new technology that's come out that gets rid of the glass that's on there, and it's truly a flexible solar panel. It's supposed to give more output in low light conditions. It can contour to really any lines. It's got glue on it. Standard MC4 connections, all that good stuff. So let's get the box open and take a look at it and see what we get. And right there's the SKU code. And that is the solar panel. All right, so it really is rolled up 360 degrees and it does look like it's got some of that tape on there. So we'll get the manual out and we'll look at it. We'll see exactly what's in there. All right, let's take a look at this. Features and all that stuff are in here. All right, so it's flexible, can be fit. So it's showing a difference between SIGS thin film versus polysilicon. And that's all rigid and everything. So this is supposed to be essentially all around better. Waterproof, lightweight, glass free, stable output. It's flexible. So you get an 18 month warranty, year and a half, that's good. Here's the dimensions. They look like they are about the same length. The 200 watt panel is just two of them put together, essentially. Two of the 100 watts put together. This is how to use it and how to attach it in front of a trailer. You do have to have a charge controller and a battery, obviously. You can hook it up into a power station. So we will be trying both of these methods. You can series, you can parallel them. So that's pretty good. Again, the specs, solar efficiency 16%. We should get around 4 amps. And it's just over 4 pounds. That's pretty decent. And those are just questions. And that's it for the book. All right, so we're gonna get this thing laid out and see how it looks. All right, we got it laid out here. This thing is pretty massive, so we had to lay it across quite a ways on the tailgate of a truck. If you look, the panel is super thin, and that's how they're gonna achieve that flexibility, along with this SIGS technology in here. It doesn't look like a normal panel, how a normal mono or polycrystalline panel or any panel today looks. It just looks like little wires, little U-shaped wires. Right there is the information. So you can do 1,000 volts DC, which is pretty standard. Decent MC4 connections. They feel good. The wires feel good. Into your box here, 20 amps, IP68 waterproof. So again, this is a nice looking panel. It can contour to many things. And again, the benefit here is you can literally roll it on itself. Now you're not gonna be able to squish it flat because you would end up breaking it, but you can roll it and we will roll it again to show. But it's got this tape here, which is like a tar substance. There it is. It's like a tar-shaped substance. But yeah, we're gonna roll this thing up on itself to show you that it's actually 360-degree foldable or rollable. So there you go. It does roll in 360 degrees. All right, so we're just gonna talk about what SIGS technology is real quick because it's pretty new. We don't know much about it, but we are going to test it and figure it out. So it's some type of copper gallium mixture. It's a thin film solar technology, basically. And it's durable, it's lightweight, it's waterproof. As we've seen, it's 360 degree flexible. IP68 waterproof, which it does look like. It is sealed very well here, and everything is like a nice smooth gel coat on here. It gives a stable output. It's lightweight and easy to transport. Yeah, this thing does roll up and fold up, so it shouldn't give no problem with getting it around for transportation or nothing like that. They say it's 70% lighter and 95% thinner, and it definitely is compared to your standard glass panels. So other than that, we're gonna get it out. We're gonna do two tests on it. The first test, we're gonna just have it plugged into a small battery pack that we know can take 120 watts of solar, but it has an internal charge controller for 80 watts. So this thing should put out the full 80 watts, hopefully. And then we'll move into a battery test with it. And just to give you an idea of how long it is, this is on an 8-foot extended dually bed. Just to give you an idea, so if anybody out there with a pickup truck is thinking about putting it on there, you will need one of the extended beds, because this is pretty long for either one, for the 100 watt or the 200 watt. The 200 watt is just wider. So this is an option to put it on here. With the tonneau cover, it might be hard to roll up, but we'll see. All right, we do have the panel just laid flat out here on the ground, and the sun is at about 11 o'clock position from the panel, so it's not too bad. We will check the output here, which we got 28 volts on the short circuit. So 31.5 is what it's rated at. So a little bit low, but if we angle the panel, I'm sure we'll get more. We're gonna get this thing hooked up out here, this power pack, and see what it does. Okay, we have everything set up out here. We got a Renergy battery pack. If you haven't seen the video on this, this thing's a beast. Click the link above. We're just gonna go ahead and plug the cord right into this and begin charging. The blue lights came on the Renergy. And let's see what we're getting from the solar panel. About 18 watts, 23 watts. Let's get this thing still here. Sorry about all the movement, guys and girls. So there you got 38 watts, 42, 43. We'll just let it keep going up and see where it peaks out at. And this thing is internally regulated to 80 watts. So if it hits 80 watts and doesn't go above it, it's because the battery pack is regulated at 80 watts. So we're getting about half of the rated power out. 4950 watts, and that's laying flat. So we're gonna go ahead and adjust it and see if we can get any difference here. No, it doesn't look like it did any better. We just rotated it on the grass to see. So we got about 50 watts laying flat, so not too bad. So that's laying flat. Sorry about that. There's rocks underneath here trying to get this thing stabilized. All right, we'll go ahead and try and move this thing around and see if we can get any better efficiency out of it. All right, huge improvement with angling it. So we went to about 68 there. 75 was the peak. So 75 watts peak. We're running about 60 watts right now. And that's just with it kind of angled weird. So we're gonna go ahead and try and set this thing up properly. All right, we have the panels set up, angled towards the sun. And we are now bringing in over 70 watts. As you can see right there, we are at 77 watts, 3.5 amps, 22 volts. Some clouds passing, but definitely doing good. We're gonna see how close to that 80 mark we can get with this. We probably won't get exactly 80 because, again, this is regulated at 80 watts, but we'll try it on something bigger here in a second. All right, so it looks like we're maintaining around 67 watts going into this battery pack. And again, we think that this is the limiting factor right now. It is set up. On a slight angle, and the sun is shining down into it. So, as you can see, yeah, we'll get a different battery out here, different charge controller, and we'll see if we can squeeze a little more power out of it. Maintaining 67 watts, 17 volts. If you look right here, we had 3.94 amps peak. Watts peak were 78.3, so this is limited to 80, so it is pulling exactly what it needs to. So yeah, let's get the bigger battery on here and see what we can get. All right, it is just after 10 a.m. We wanted to show you, this is actually what the panel's producing right now, 2.56 amps at 56 watts. And this is what it's charging at after all of the losses and the MPP charger. So the actual number we're looking at right there is 56 watts, 2.58 amps, and it's just after 10 a.m. All right, it's about 11 o'clock, and we are bringing in 71 watts. So we'll go and check the peak, what we had. All right, we're bringing in 71 watts at 3.33 amps. We had a maximum of 80 watts so far out of this panel. So the panel is 80% efficient so far, and it's 11 a.m. All right, it is just before 12 noon. If you see there, 11:52. We are pulling in 4.10 amps, 87 watts, 88 you see there. We're gonna go into the record, and if you see there, we hit 95 watts in this panel at some time. So this thing is very, very efficient. We're gonna go ahead and look at the other app now and see what we're getting. All right, we got about 86 watts coming in. It's showing the same thing, 4.11 amps. And just before noon, so it's doing very well. This thing is at least 90% efficient right now. Just wanted to show that we're actually hitting 91 watts. So we're at 91% efficiency with this panel right now. You see we're refreshing it, 93. This thing's doing amazing right now. 94.
So we're at about 94% efficiency right now with this thing, because this is a 100 watt panel. Amazing, it's doing perfect. I wanted to show the solar panel is getting over 100 watts. Amazing. Look at that, it's pumping out power right now. 107 watts. Absolutely amazing, and it's right at noon, so this is gonna be the best time to get some sun. Wow. Absolutely amazing. We'll let it run to about 1 o'clock. And it's constantly pumping out over 100 watts now. More than what it's rated at. This panel is absolutely amazing. No issues at all. 19, 20 volts coming in. 4.61 amps from the panel. This thing's doing great. Alright guys, it's just before 1. And as you can see there, we are pumping out over 100 watts still. That's going to conclude the test for this panel.